afternoon, YouTube. Support you and I'm Tim Cooley. Welcome to my channel. To everybody who subscribed, thank you for being subscribed to my channel. It means a lot. And you don't have to, and you are, so thank you for that. To anybody, a newcomer, please like and subscribe if you like my videos. You know what I'm saying? So, right now I'm about to talk about the Week 13 movie, Road to Infinity War Challenge. Captain America, Winter Soldier. What can I say about this movie? This movie was a spectacle. Somewhat like Infinity War. It was amazing seeing them come together. Like, I haven't watched this movie this year yet. And it was amazing to see. Just took me back to the hype before the movie, knowing that Cap, Iron Man, Black Panther, Spider-Man, Vision, Black Widow, Hawkeye, Scarlet Witch, like War Machine, Falcon, all these people are gonna collide. Like, just knowing that, and it just referred me to how damaged the team is, you know what I'm saying? Like, Infinity War is gonna be a treat, y'all. Like, the person who thought about the Road to Infinity War Challenge, congratulations. Like, it just makes the movie so much hyper. Like, this movie was straight up fantastic. Like, it was groundbreaking in itself. Like, Russo brothers, they really balanced most of the characters. Some have issues, like mine. Like, issues are nitpicky with this movie. Like, Clint, I think he's on the wrong side, because I feel like he's more of Iron Man's friend. Even in the movie, they seem more buddy-buddy than Cap is with Clint. So Clint does not make sense, and it was too much of a sacrifice with his family and everything. I think that's why he lashed out at Iron Man in prison, because he realized what the fuck he did. This, he was thinking, yo, I'm disappointing my kids, because we were supposed to go to Waterworld or some stuff like that. I'm like, dude, you in prison now. You wanted Corona. Your family's gonna be pissed. I don't know how his family dynamic's gonna be sitting with Scott Long. That dude spent his whole movie trying to have a relationship with his kid and his ex-wife and all that. Then he just goes back and does something that'll put him in prison. Like, if he ain't a self-sabotager, then I don't know what he is. Like, goddamn, yo, he just went back on everything he stood for in the first movie. Those are the nitpicky stuff I have against it. You know what I'm saying? But anybody, like Cap, Iron Man, I feel like I understood their motives behind everything. Ain't it trippy that Cap has Captain America in his name, but he's basically like, fuck the law, the US Constitution. Like, he ain't following no rules but his own. Like, his rightful morals. That's something to admire a little bit. That even the person with the name of the country that does some wrong stuff at times, it's basically like, nah, this is not morally right, so I'm gonna stand for it and I'm gonna be against it. I'm just not gonna lay down, you know what I'm saying? Because that's what the kids are doing now, you know, with the marches and everything. Anyway, it just dawned on my mind when I was watching it yesterday. Anyway, this movie is still fantastic. Still give it a 9 out of 10. I mean, I give minus 1 because of those nitpicky stuff I mentioned. There's more, but it's just nitpicky, like I said. This movie's fantastic. If you haven't watched it, what have you been doing, bruh? What have you been doing? If you are watching it, then you know, man. You know what I'm talking about. And basically, that's my thoughts about the movie. After probably a 6th time I've watched it, it feels like a different experience every time. That's something to behold, if you know what I'm saying. Anyway, like and subscribe my channel, you know what I'm saying? Join. I almost went Logan Paul on it. We're like strongest family on YouTube. anyway, yeah. Deuces.